This is something I've never told anyone before. Something so strange, so terrible. Forgive me if I sound quite mad, but it's true all the same. Sebastian saw the face of God.
I'd like to hear about that.
Yes. Yes, sir. One long ago summer, sitting right here in this garden, Sebastian said to me, "Mother, listen to this." And he read me Herman Melville's description of the Encantadas, the Galapagos Islands. He read me that description and said we had to go there. And so we did go there that summer on a chartered boat, a four-masted schooner, looking as close as possible to the sort of boat that Melville would have sailed on. We saw the Encantadas. But on the Encantadas, we saw something that Melville hadn't written about. We saw the great sea turtles crawl up out of the sea for their annual egg laying. Once a year, the female of the sea turtles crawls up out of the equatorial sea onto the blazing sand beach of a volcanic island to dig a pit in the sand and deposit her eggs there. It's a long and dreadful thing, the depositing of the eggs in the sand pits. And when it's finished, the exhausted female turtle crawls back to the sea, half dead. She never sees her offspring, but we did. Sebastian knew exactly when the sea turtle eggs would be hatched, and we returned in time for it.
You went back?
In time to witness the hatching of the sea turtles and their desperate flight to the sea. The narrow beach, the color of caviar, was all in motion. The sky was in motion, too, full of flesh-eating birds. And the noise of the birds, their horrible savage cries as they circled over the narrow black beach of the Encantadas, while the new-hatched sea turtles scrambled out of their sand pits and started their race to the sea.
Race to the sea?
To escape the flesh-eating birds that made the sky almost as black as the beach. And I said, "Sebastian, no. No, it's not like that." But he made me look. He made me see that terrible sight.
What was not like that?
Life. I said, "No. No. That's not true." But he said, "It is." He said, "Look, Violet. Look, there on the shore." And I looked and saw the sand, all alive, all alive, as the new-hatched sea turtles made their dash to the sea while the birds hovered and swooped to attack. And hovered and swooped to attack. They were diving down on the sea turtles, turning them over to expose their soft undersides, tearing their undersides open, and rending and eating their flesh. Sebastian guessed that possibly only 0.01% of their number would escape to the sea.
Nature is not created in the image of man's compassion.
Nature is cruel. Sebastian knew it all along, was born knowing it, but not I. I said, "No, no, those are only birds, turtles, not us." I didn't know then it was us, that we are all of us trapped by this devouring creation. I wouldn't face the horror of the truth. Even that last day in the Encantadas, when Sebastian left me and spent the whole blazing equatorial day in the crow's nest of the schooner watching that thing on the beach until it was too dark to see. And when he came down the rigging, he said, "Well, now I've seen him." And he meant God.
Do you believe he saw God?
He saw the whole thing there that day on the beach. But I was like you. I said no. I refused to believe, until suddenly last summer, I learned my son was right. That what he had shown me in the Encantadas was the horrible, the inescapable truth.